Here we're asked to graph and label the intercepts for x equals negative 3. Now this is a very special line, so let's look at it first by plotting points. Notice x is negative 3, so if I choose anything for y, say negative 2, 0, or 2, x, for those corresponding y values, will always have to be negative 3. That's what the equation is telling me. 2 points determine a line, but here I have 3. Let's graph these 3 points up and see what's happening. Okay, so this is my x-axis, and this here will be my y-axis. Let's choose 1 unit for the scale. Here's a blank Cartesian coordinate system. Now I'm ready to plot my point. So negative 3 comma negative 2 is right about there. Negative 3 comma 0, that's my x-intercept. And then negative 3 comma 2. So 2 points determine a line. When I plot these points out, you can see the line that it gives us here is a vertical line. And that's always going to be the case. Whenever you have x equals a number, you're going to get a vertical line. Okay, but it also wanted us to label the x and y intercepts. Okay, so this one had an x-intercept. The x-intercept here was negative 3 comma 0, so that's my label, and there happens to be no y-intercepts. And there you go. So it looks a little bit funny, x equals negative 3. We'll see later that this equation represents a graph that's not a function. And there it is.